All right, let's talk about tropical landscapes. Hi, and welcome back. We're going to talk about tropical landscapes today because of something that occurred in my dad's neighborhood. So I thought I'd take a second and tell you what hat racking is and why it's harmful. You see, when things are growing, as a branch is continuing up, the meristematic tissue out at the tip is where the dividing and new leaves and branches and so on are being formed. And as a branch goes along, it has what's called a dominant leader, and then there's a secondary branch coming out behind it and so on, and then that pattern continues on up the branch. Well, in proper arboreal trimming practices, what you do is you just take off, if this is what your branch looks like, you just take off the dominant leader, which is then leaves this one. If the branch looks like this, and you take this one off, now you have this one, but you still have a growing tip. Well, the hormones that cause the thing to grow are out in this branch, so when it's cut off, they're transferred here and cause this branch to then continue to grow and to branch out this way. But what it really does, it can reduce the crown, but it causes things to bush out a little bit. That's why people have said if you want something to branch or bush out, you trim it back. You cut off that meristematic tissue out on the end and cause the what are called dormant eyes or buds to pop and spring. Well, what hat racking is if you go back to our branch like this and go back down the branch, all they do is come way down the branch and just cut it off. Sever it completely. And this is what it looks like. Now, it's unfortunate that they did this to these trees because of a couple of things. One is the aesthetic appeal is just horrible. They're just as unsightly as they can be. Secondly, it turns what was once a big, beautiful oak tree into a bush if it even survives this cutting back. And don't forget that trees need leaves to photosynthesize food for themselves. So those trees now have no leaves with which to produce food. The third thing is they now, when they come back, your branch look like this with leaders, and they continue to grow like this. Once it's chopped off, a bunch of buds or dormant eyes will sprout at the end, and you'll have a bunch of really weak branching structures that can be destroyed in storms. And the final thing is, I used to be friends with one of the top arborists in the county who wrote some of the county trimming regulations. And at one time, hat racking trees was illegal in Palm Beach County. I don't know if it still is or not, but you can see from these photographs or from the video of just how unsightly this thing is. I think what they were trying to do was get some light down to the ground so that the grass could grow there, but this is not the way to go about it. Anyway, that's what hat racking is and how it can affect your trees, and so you absolutely don't want to do that ever. If you can have a crown reduction pruning, it pulls the shape of the tree down, but it retains all of the growing characteristics. I supervised over at my dad's house last year a very, very severe crown reduction pruning by a local arborist company of his mango tree, which was really big. And we took it down tremendously, but we did it correctly. And now, 1 year later, his mango tree is covered with blooms and he'll have mangoes again this year. These oak trees will take years to recover again, even if they do survive. So thanks a lot for watching. I know it was a little bit off topic, but the sight of these trees is just too much every time I pull up at my dad's house. If you enjoyed the video, you might want to subscribe so you can see more. I write on the coastal Florida lifestyle and exploring around Florida. And if you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up down below. Or if you have any comments on hat racking or other tropical landscape questions or comments, I'd love to hear them. Add them down below. Thanks again for watching. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.